If you work from a home office, what happens if you lose power and don't have an installed solar plus battery system? In a previous video, I reviewed the EcoFlow Delta Pro battery. I powered my entire home with the battery to see how long it would last. Now, I will see how long I can operate DroneQuote on battery backup. Unlike the home backup video, I now have a 200 watt solar panel providing power in the daytime hours. Plus, the load is much lower. So what am I powering? How long a battery lasts depends on the load you put on it or whether or not you have solar. For this experiment, I'll be powering the following items at one point or another from most to least use. Router and modem, a Mac mini and two monitors. I'll be charging a MacBook Pro and my iPhone, AirPods and an Apple Watch. And if it gets a little cold, I may use a space heater. The Delta Pro will be powering everything through a series of extension cords and power strips. And even though it seems like I'm plugging in a high load, besides the lights and heater, I don't think I'll be running more than 140 watts constantly during work hours. To help increase the battery life, I purchased a 200 watt solar panel that I'll be plugging into the Delta Pro. The panel cost me $165 and I got it on Amazon with a 50 foot cable to plug into the solar panel so I'd have enough room to run the cable down to the basement rather than bring the heavy battery upstairs. I did have to solder an XE60 adapter to plug the solar panel into the battery so I know how much wattage I'm getting out of it. I also got this from Amazon. Because the solar panel orientation is critical to output, I will start the morning with the panels facing southeast. Around the middle of the day, I'll go due south, and in the afternoon, southwest. That will help increase the solar panel's output during the day. And how am I measuring all of this? Now, while this isn't precise laboratory test conditions, I will be taking measurements to keep track of data so we can know how much power we started with and how much power we got out of the battery as a sum. To test the amount of output from the battery, I'm using this kilowatt hour meter I purchased on Amazon for about $20. I love this thing because it lets me measure electricity usage around the house. I'll run the power out of the battery through this one outlet. As for the electricity input, I'll be reading the data from the EcoFlow app and from the battery itself, but I'll use a watt meter between the panel and the battery as I mentioned earlier. Now, before we start the experiment, I estimate to get 3 days out of this battery with the solar panel and lighter electrical load helping the battery go a longer distance. Okay, so I started this experiment at 0900 hours on a cloudy day and placed the solar panel in my yard on the west side of my house. This is important for two reasons. The solar panel didn't start getting sunlight until about 10:40 because my house was casting a shadow on the west lawn. Second, the cloudy morning didn't let the panel start working until a little bit after 11:30 in the morning. The solar panel generated 867 watt hours during the first day, or 0.867 kilowatt hours. On the first day, I finished work around 18:47, almost 9.5 hours from the start. I was surprised I had only brought the battery down to 77% and used 1.18 kilowatt hours. I thought that the prediction of 3 days would be short and perhaps I'd get more out of the battery. That is until the following day. I checked the battery early the next morning and was shocked to see it down to 42% from the night before when I had last seen it at 77%. It seemed that my office, including the router and modem, had drawn down almost 800 watt hours from the evening to that morning. However, the second day I had a very sunny forecast and I knew I'd make up some of the output. I also rotated the panel every hour and a half to keep up with the sun's path and to feed the battery more juice. The second day, I got 1,053 watt hours or 1.05 kilowatt hours. When the second day ended for me at 1952, after producing more power with the solar panel, the battery was down to 34%. I figured I would get a half day with the battery the following morning, especially since the next day's forecast was sunny and clear. Unfortunately, I got an email in the morning at 0857 from my Ring alarm telling me that my security system was running on cellular backup. That meant the battery had died just shy of 48 hours after I started my experiment. I have to be honest and tell you, I was disappointed. So what did I learn from all this? Well, first, I did this experiment between October 5th and 6th, when there's less sunlight than in June. If I had done this in June, I would have gotten further with the battery since I would have charged it more. During the experiment, I ran two things I would not do. I used the space heater for about 20 minutes at one point, and it pushed the battery to around 800 watts of output. Second, I plugged in my PlayStation 4 to the battery, and between my office computer plus the modem and router, the battery hit about 250 watts of output. I wouldn't do that again if this had been an actual outage. I also worked on my laptop more to conserve the battery. Now here's the part that perplexed me. I got 867 watt hours the first day and 1,053 hours the second day for a total of 1,920 watt hours or 1.92 kilowatt hours. However, the battery output is only 3.2 kilowatt hours, but this battery has a capacity of 3.6 kilowatt hours, which means 10% was left in reserves, as you can see in this image. That part makes sense, but what about the 1.9 kilowatt hours I put into the battery with the solar panel? If we say there's an efficiency loss of 20% on the solar generation, I should still have another 1.5 kilowatt hours out of the battery. Furthermore, when I plugged in the battery at 10%, the meter showed me an input of 4.2 kilowatt hours. Some of this can be attributed to efficiency losses, and the fan was running the whole time it was charging since the battery input hit 1800 watts. The math, though, doesn't seem to add up for me, and I don't understand electrical engineering enough to account for the 1.5 kilowatt hours I believe I was missing. If anyone watching can chime in and educate me, I welcome it with open arms. So here's the question. What is it worth to you to back up your office and run your business? I wouldn't go through the trouble in an actual power outage to continue working in my office. I'd simply pick up the MacBook Pro and go to work from the coffee shop. However, with a long-term outage that lasts longer than an entire day, the price point of this battery at just under $3,000 may start to make sense for some people. What do you think? This solution is more palatable than a home battery at $15,000, if you ask me. Let me know what you think about this experiment of mine. I'd be curious to hear your opinion, especially regarding the electricity I can't account for.